Okay, are we live? Okay, we are live. Cool, cool, cool. Oh, thank goodness. Alright. Hello, hello. Sorry to get started a little late. Schedules were a little borked, but it's fine. Let's adjust this camera a little bit. There you go. Hello everyone, my name is Paolo Jossa. I am the Young Adult Librarian here at the Govins Branch of the Enoch Prattree Library in Baltimore, Maryland. Today, our program is, as you can see, the weekly manga drawing lessons weekly. I don't know why they keep switching that order every time I look at it. Anyway, essentially, this program is, this online, all virtual program, is here to help you learn how to draw anime and manga characters step by step in weekly sessions, and build up a binder of your best drawings to become a real artist. Supplies for the program will be available at the Govins Branch on a first-come, first-served basis, meaning you'll be handed a binder, some sheets of really nice paper, some really cool pencils, like the actual type of pencils that you'd use when you're when you're drawing manga and anime, I think a couple of markers, the works. In celebration of Black History Month as well, now I think I got the dates wrong here, because the other thing that we're doing here in the Govins Branch is take and make of Draw Your Own Superhero Black History Month edition. Now, this is supposed to take place after the first 2 weeks of February, but since it says it starts right now, I better get going in terms of prepping those take and makes. Still, we will be focusing, probably starting next lesson, depending on how much time I have with this lesson and the continuing one. We'll be focusing on focusing on African American superheroes in order to celebrate Black History Month. It is February after all. The alternative is to be celebrating like Valentine's Day, and I don't think there's that many Valentine's Day themed superheroes or anime characters other than Faye Valentine, but I don't recommend trying to draw her. Anyway, so I think this is, at least today, we're gonna use this time to take one last stab at the drawing that we continued from last time. But and also just as a bit of refresher, this Google Drive of all the manga drawing lessons, weekly lessons, are also available here on this Google Drive that's free for everyone. It should be under tiny URL, it's called Manga Drawing Lessons folder, I think. It should be in the email that's been sent, or in the Discord channel in the Discord server, which we also have as Enoch Prattree Library, specifically for teens. There we go. I'm just adjusting my chair. I do love this thing. It really fits. It's ergonomic. It's very good. Anyway, just to update y'all, we've added the next few lessons afterwards, after Black History Month, because we're focusing more on, like, continuing the anime and manga thing. But I also put in, more tutorials and recommendations for tutorials and recommendations for manga drawing for manga drawing weekly. That's just a couple of YouTube channels and a couple more books. Anyway, as such. Anyway, so let's get started, shall we? Now, before we were focusing on you were focusing on this book called The Complete Guide to Drawing Action Manga, a Step-by-Step Artist Handbook, which is available to borrow at the Enoch, in the Enoch Preffy Library, and should be available in most retailers. It was published in, like, 2018, I'd like to say. 2019. So it should still be a relatively recent book and relatively easy to find. I highly recommend it. It's got a lot of great poses if you go through it all, and a lot of great tips. I do recommend this as an intermediate book, not what's called not directly beginners, which is why we're starting here, since we've had several lessons already. Now, we're going to go over how to illustrate, how Shoko illustrates. How Shoko goes through his illustrations. Notice that he has 1, 2, and it's going to go to the next page, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, stages. Now, this is kind of a very much simplifying it, because the getting from here to here is vastly different from, like, getting from the draft to the line drawing. Because if you notice, this is basically an already finished sketch of, like, a pose. And on top of that, they're adding just where the sketches, where all the details will go. And then, like, the full inked line drawing, which is ready for color. If you notice, like, very, very fine line work here. Unfortunately, we're not even there yet. If we're looking at the thing that we were doing, click, boom, boom. If we were looking at, so this is just a sketch practice sheet. Oh, no, I'm not even there yet. Hold on. CSP, transition, ping, there we go. This is my sketch practice sheet, but essentially we're here. We're basically still at the drafting stage, because we've already gotten a rough sketch. My hand here. I'm already out of frame. Like, I'm trying to touch the drawing. Immediately touch the drawing with your hand. You're going into another dimension. No. As you can see here, we're still in the drafting stage, since just under it, we've managed to finish, or rather, managed to construct, like, a better, in his drawing, rough sketch, and we're still on the draft version of it. We're adding, at least what I'm trying to do is try to place all the features of where Tracer is, of all the features of Tracer, specifically, various, like, kind of where all her stuff is going. And when I mean stuff, I mean, like, the chrono accelerator right in front of her, because that kind of takes place, like, it's basically a third boob, because right chest, left chest, and then the chrono accelerator just sits right on top of it. So I'm just trying to, like, find a way to make that look like it's, like, out there. In terms of construction. I don't know if I'm doing well, honestly. it's kind of rough. Hopefully we'll get there as soon as we get into, like, the third sketch. But right now I'm just trying to build out the form a little bit more. And this is gonna be rough, because we're gonna need to draw her, like, I don't know what these are, like, flippers or something? Never been good at construction, but here we go. If you wanna do it, baby, tonight. didn't know that this had a... Oh, here we go to the next track. Yeah, checking to see if we're still streaming. Yes, we are. We're good. Alright, so. It's a good thing I had, like, a bit of a chance to, it's called get away from this drawing a little bit more. Because I want to be able to, like, really denote, like, there is, like, this chunky thing, like, sticking out of their chest. This really mechanical, getting like a slightly better view of this normal accelerator thingy. I don't actually know what it's called. I just know that it's like a thingy that's attached to poor Tracer here. Like it's kind of like this. Need to show like depth. Trying to show depth in like a 3D plane. That's a little hard, isn't it? Then again, it could just get bogged down into details of like the one thing. Something in her back? I just realized that. Oh, how frustrating. That's why I'm not really, like, I love Blizzard characters, currently. Not really right now due to current issues. But, like, I do love, like, the extraneous details that they have on, like, their everything. It's, like, a fun mess, essentially, of like being able to figure out where things go. Even at this stage, it's good to find a way to vary your line thickness because it it's good to vary your line thickness because, you know, it's kind of able to add more detail. Oh, man. That's good. I think I need to shorten this a little bit, though. So I'm gonna say that while this part is a little big, that little corset thing, I bet would be riding up because, like, you're basically dashing up front, and like when you think about it this way, when you're moving your shoulder up, part of the cloth, especially it's stiff. Out like a leather whatever jacket type thing, a bomber jacket type thing that she's wearing, it wouldn't like stretch, like it wouldn't stretch like this, rather it would be pulled up. So like kind of in an effort to, we're gonna pull it up like this and have it just like go around here. It's like here. I think, like, if the belt go here. Like the belt thing that's kind of flying in the air. Oh, No, I just realized what these are. These are her pistols. Like, she's got a little, like, mechanism thing where she just flips them out and then the pistols are in her hand already. I didn't even realize that. That's so cute. Which kind of makes sense. You are a shooter character. Straight up copying the fingers from the what's it called from the reference picture, because good golly molly, I'm not good at drawing fingers yet. If we assume the same bomber jacket thing is here, we're gonna try to make it so that it's kind of crumply. I'm gonna skip that song because I think it has English lyrics. I'm like, that's inappropriate.
Bye.
starting to kind of come together a little bit more, which is good. It's good to kind of zoom out a little bit and try to figure out, like, where else we can add more stuff, what needs more detail, less detail, that sort of thing. I really like, despite the first draft, or rather the first, kind of pass here of, like, what are even these things called? Her literal and figurative guns here, that we can kind of get the feeling of, like, oh, this is some a little bit of foreshortening here. And kind of a similar effect here. It's gonna be a little trickier though, because now not only do we have to draw her guns on the other side, but like upside down also, which is gonna be fun. And upside down and also farther away. The position here kind of is similar. That kind of be like cheating, but you know what? I might as well show you. Alright, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna select this layer, and we are going to literally make this a little smaller. Literally select this bit of her arm, because it's basically going to be the same, and copy it. Now, we just have a copy of that arm. We're gonna take the opacity a little low, and we're gonna move it just underneath this one. And we're gonna turn it. Gonna move it. Make it smaller. Smaller still. Make it a little bigger. Voila. Now, let's pop up the opacity a little better. Underneath here, so we can just literally draw over it and trace it. I don't feel too bad because, indeed, this is tracer. Alright. It's not gonna look perfect because we literally traced it. Let's add. Let's liquefy it a little bit. Distance and this angle, this looks fine. We'll add a little more detail later. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. How terrifying. Jesus Christ, how terrifying. That really was kind of cheating a little bit. That was literally tracing from the reference image. But to be fair, we did modify it a little bit and adjust it to make it kind of fit the square peg fitting a square peg into a round hole a little bit. And this is just the draft. If I were to continue this, if we were not doing like Black History Month and the superhero thing, then I would probably add more time to really refine some of the smaller details that are there. Speaking of which, supposed to be a little patch here. There we go. And her stripes. There we go. Good enough. Razor here has some ridiculous, what's it called, calves. As she should, because she is supposed to be like a speedster, rather the speedster character. cannot draw shoes to save my life. Cannot draw shoes to save my life. Damn. Lost some time, unfortunately. Despite starting late, I actually do need to finish up at around the same time. Scheduling conflicts. Still. That little basic drawing from 5 feet, 5 feet away at this point. No. This is basically an okay draft. Be able to like add the, like you can't really see the Chronox South Raider in the back, so we're gonna assume add a little bit of like flair here in terms of literal speed lines. Maybe even like a road. Horizon. Much better. In fact, definitely much better. Oh, also, quick trick in terms of like placing people in like perspective. The horizon line should be around where the eye level is, unless you're looking, unless you're kind of creating like, oh, worm's eye view or bird's eye view, which is why you kind of slap the horizon line right there and then use that to kind of create a sense of perspective as to like where they're running. Where they're running and putting them in an object in space, that sort of thing. But like ideas of buildings and very simple. But that's a good place to start. And this is like enough detail to like really start inking if you really want to. But for now, I think it's a good place to stop. Because it's already 4:30, unfortunately. And this is kind of where we need to end. Yeah. Alright, so thank you for joining us in this relatively shortened version of Manga Drawing Lessons Weekly. Next week, we're going to pivot into African-American history, Black History Month, and we're going to try to create our own black superhero. Or, failing that, trying to find like bits and pieces from other black superheroes that we like and admire, and like put them together into a character design thingy. That should be fun. Anyway, thanks for coming in, and see you next week.